हेलो यंग फिजिक्स लर्नर, वेलकम टू माय क्लास. दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 5 अंडर द यूनिट अल्टरनेटिंग करंट. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द रेस्ट 4 सर्किट्स एंड आफ्टरवर्ड वी विल डिस्कस इन डिटेल अबाउट द LCR सर्किट. सो रेस्ट 4 सर्किट्स आर L सर्किट, LC सर्किट, CR सर्किट, LR सर्किट. सो वी विल डिस्कस दीज 4 सर्किट. टू अंडरस्टैंड LCR टॉपिक यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड द बेस सर्किट्स which are given in this chapter. So let's start with the next circuit, that is L circuit. Those who are new to this video, I want to say that you must have to see the previous video because the topic is linked with the previous one so that you can easily understand this topic. So first of all, click the previous video and then come to this video. This is for new viewers. So this information is only for the new viewers. This is AC mains. This one is a coil and the inductance of this coil is L. I told that coil, if you want to understand the elaborated view of this inductance or inductor, you must have to go through EMI, electromagnetic induction, which is chapter number 6 of NCERT book, and you can easily understand what is inductor and inductance. So I can provide you that link too so that you may understand the base of inductor. Okay, so here L is an inductor and this is AC mains. AC mains means what? The supply which provide the AC, that means alternating current. The voltage corresponding to this AC mains is given as I have done in the previous circuit. So V is equal to V naught sine omega t. Now omega here is angular frequency and the formula for it is most important 2 pi by t or 2 pi nu. T is time period, nu is frequency. Alternating current is a sine wave. And generally it is a sine wave, and that is why alternating current must have some frequency which is 50 hertz in India, and time period, that is time to complete one wave. So that is the formula, and to understand the wave concept you must have to go through with the class 11th wave and oscillation topic, as I told earlier. Otherwise the short overview corresponding to this topic is sufficient. Clear? So omega is equal to 2 pi by t or 2 pi nu. So what you have to do, you have to apply Kirchhoff law. Kirchhoff law. According to Kirchhoff law, we will apply the Kirchhoff second law, that is summation of all the EMF that should be equal to zero. So on the basis of this, the supply voltage here, it is V. And this should be equal to the voltage across this inductor, and that voltage is represented by small e, which is the induced EMF corresponding to this coil. Clear? Ye jo aapko maine concept bataya, this is given in the last chapter, chapter number 6, electromagnetic induction. So V here, you can write it as L di by dt. Now this relation was proved in the last chapter by the flux linkage law. So you can get this relation and you can directly apply here this relation by using Kirchhoff law. V is equal to L di by dt. So here V is equal to L di by dt. Now where is that minus sign? Because we have placed the induced EMF value in the right side, that is why we don't need to apply here the minus sign. Otherwise that minus sign is must be here with the L di by dt term in the LHS form, in the LHS site. Clear? So here V is equal to L di by dt, where L is the inductance, I is current, induced current, T is time period, and here V is the voltage supply. Now we can put the value here, V is equal to V naught sine omega t, that is equal to L di by dt. What is our preference, what we are going to do? If you want to consider the circuit, that means if it is asked in the examination, describe L circuit, as I told earlier for C circuit and R circuit. So that means what? Ye small question indicate kar raha hai that you have to find out first of all current, then average power, then wave formation, then phasor, and then you will write the conclusion that whether the current is leading or lagging. So that is overall description of the one circuit, any one circuit. Here we are taking L circuit. So that description is asked in 3 marks question. So you have to prepare for all these steps, and these steps are same for all kind of circuit. So here V naught sin omega t is equal to L di by dt. You will write afterward that V naught divided by L sin omega t dt, that is equal to di, because next we are going to find out current. So current can be identified by taking it at one side, and now because it is di, so we will integrate in both side. So integrating both side, we'll get it V naught over L integration of sin omega t dt, that is equal to integration of ti di. Afterward you will write it as V naught over L. What is the integration of sin omega t? Sin omega t is cos omega t with minus sign and divided by omega. That is the integration value. Now because we have not applied the limit here, so we need to take one constant. So this is the constant of integration, and integration here that will come as I. The value is from 0 to I, that is I here. So this is the overall integration on both sides. Afterward you will take the term V naught over L cos omega t divided by omega. This term will become 0. Why this becomes 0? Because this is a constant term. Constant means what? It is a constant of integration, so it does not depend on variable. What is the variable here? Variable here is time. So this constant is independent of time. So if it is independent of time, and because this is a constant after the plus sign, so by balancing the equation on both sides, this C term should be related to current. Are you getting my point? C term should be related to current only. By equating the both side by dimensional analysis method, we must have to equate the both side of the equation, and all the terms must have the same dimension. So this is C term. So C term must have the dimension equivalent to I. This is the I term, I equivalent term. This should be the I equivalent term. This is I term. So C should be I. That means current. If C is current and it does not depend on variable time, that means it is time independent current. And because we are talking about alternating current, and alternating current itself means that the current which varies with time, that cannot stop along with the time. So it should not be constant with respect to time. So that is why this C term is not possible. Is this point clear to you? If C is independent of time, C cannot exist. Clear? So that is why here C is equal to 0, and we have got only the one term in left hand side equal to I. So that is the logic behind C having the value 0. So we will get it as V naught over omega L cos omega t, and here because I told minus sign, ye minus sign yahan par rahega. Is minus sign ko aapko dhyan rakhna hai that minus sign should be along with the integral value, because sign ka integration mein minus aata hai jab ye cos mein convert hota hai. So this is cos omega t which is equal to I. This step is clear to you? Yahan tak koi problem? अब देखो इसके बाद क्या करना है. जो ये टर्म है, बिकॉज आपको पता है ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिकल फॉर्म जो होती है, कॉस ओमेगा टी इज अ ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिकल फंक्शन. सो इफ इट इज ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिकल फंक्शन, दैट मींस व्हाट? ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिकल फंक्शन की कोई डायमेंशन नहीं होती है, तो इसका मतलब जो भी डायमेंशन है वो इस टर्म की है. दैट मींस दिस टर्म मस्ट बी इक्विवेलेंट टू आई. दैट मींस दिस टर्म इज आई टर्म. सो आई टर्म बिकॉज इट इज़ वी नॉट सो इट शुड बी आई नॉट. अगर हम इसकी कंपेरेबिलिटी करते दोनों साइड में सो आई नॉट मस्ट बी इक्विवेलेंट टू वी नॉट ओवर ओमेगा एल. माइनस साइन शुड बी हेयर विद द कॉस टर्म. सो आई नॉट शुड बी इक्वल टू वी नॉट ओवर ओमेगा एल. बाई कंपेयरिंग दीज साइड्स बाई ओम्स लॉ, तो ओम्स लॉ क्या कहता है, I should be equal to V divided by R. So this denominator term should be equivalent to R. Okay, but it is not R. R is the resistance. Resistance does not depend on angular frequency. Here omega is the angular frequency and R does not depend on angular frequency. So that means what? Ki ye term equivalent hai resistance ke, but it is not the resistance. So we give it a very this is a physical quantity which is new to you, and we give the name to this quantity as inductive reactance. When I have solved C circuit, I told it capacitive reactance because there was a capacitor. Here this is a inductor and there is an inductance value, so that is why this omega L terms must be represented by inductive reactance, which should be equal to resistance. It is equivalent to resistance in simple wire. This is a coil and resistance is for simple wire. So that means this, the representation for inductive reactance is XL. The representation for capacitive reactance is XC, X suffix C, and this is XL. And remember this current unit. Current unit is the fundamental unit, it must be ampere. V naught unit is volt. So this omega L unit must be ohm only, because volt per ohm is only equal to ampere. Here volt per ohm, resistance unit is ohm. So if resistance unit is ohm, so that is why omega L, which is represented by XL, that unit must be ohm. And this is called inductive reactance. This is a new term and you must know about this term because it will be useful later on. So unit of XL, that should be equal to ohm. Here also unit of XC is ohm. मैंने आपको I think C circuit में ये बताया नहीं था, unit should be ohm. But every time remember this inductive reactance या capacitive reactance, और भी अभी आगे एक term आने वाला है, impedance आने वाला है. So every term must have the unit equivalent to the unit of resistance. Clear? So that is why XL is equal to omega, and this is the new value. जितने भी मैं आपको ये terms बता रही हूँ reactance वाले, इसी पे based generally numericals बनते हैं circuit से. तो ये terms आप ध्यान रखना, ठीक है? अभी कुछ इस पर logical based question भी आने वाले हैं. That we will solve some questions based on AC and DC related to L circuit and C circuit. So that will be very interesting to you if you will be having some practice over these kind of circuits. Clear? So here XL is equal to omega L and this is inductive reactance. Clear? Now come to the equation. Now because we have to finalize the relation of I so that we can further identify the waveform and phasor. So come to this term and we can put here that minus of I naught cos omega t is equal to I. Now it does not look very good equation, and we cannot compare the I and V term in the wave formation. So that is why what we will do, because V is equal to V naught sin omega t, so we need to consider the I term in the same format of V term. That means sin omega t, here it is sin and here it is cos. So we need to convert this cos term into the sin term so that we can compare the two equation. So we will write here as cos theta is equal to sin 90 minus theta. So we can write sin pi by 2, 90 means what, pi by 2 minus theta, theta is omega t. We have converted this cos into sin with minus sign, and that is equal to I. Because sin is an odd function, that means what? Sin minus theta is equal to minus of sin theta. जो भी ऑड फंक्शन होते हैं उसमें क्या होता है कि एंगल जो ऑगमेंट होता है जिसे हम एंगल कहते हैं, ऑगमेंट का माइनस साइन बाहर आ जाता है. अगर ये इवन फंक्शन होता तो ऑगमेंट का माइनस साइन अंदर एब्जॉर्ब हो जाता एंड यू वुड ओनली गेट द प्लस ऑफ कॉस थीटा. कॉस इज एन इवन फंक्शन. So that is why, because sine is an odd function, so sine minus theta should be equal to minus of sine theta. So we can absorb this minus sign here inside the equation, and then we will get final terms of I, final relation of I, and then we will compare it. So I should be equal to I naught sine. This is pi by 2 minus omega t. If you will take this minus sign inside by this relation, you will get omega t minus pi by 2. So this is the equation for I, and this one is the equation for V. This is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यहीं पर आपकी ऑब्जर्वेशन आ जाती है. आप देखो फर्स्ट इक्वेशन सेकेंड इक्वेशन को कंपेयर करो तो एट टाइम t इज इक्वल टू जीरो, इफ़ यू आर पुटिंग t इज इक्वल टू जीरो, सो साइन जीरो इज जीरो, v इज इक्वल टू जीरो. क्लियर? नाउ इफ यू आर पुटिंग t इज इक्वल टू जीरो हेयर, सो इट विल कम एज साइन माइनस पाई बाई टू. सो माइनस साइन पाई बाई टू, माइनस बाहर आ जाएगा, माइनस साइन पाई बाई टू. दैट मीन्स करेंट विद द माइनस वैल्यू इज हैविंग द पीक टर्म एट दैट साइड. So we can draw the wave formation here, and we can get the wave formation here in this manner. This is I and V, this one is T, and if you are taking at time t is equal to 0, this is 0 time, this is the t axis, so this is t is equal to 0. Here let it be t is equal to t by 4, then t by 2, then 3t by 4, then 2t, not 2t, t. Clear? This is the one time period, time to complete one wave. So at time t is equal to 0, if we are putting 0 here, so we will get v0. So v should be 0 here, and here the I value should be here. If we are putting t 0, so I value should be minus of 1. So minus 1 means what? That side. The current value should start from here. Clear? By this equation, minus means what? Below the horizontal line. Plus means what? Above the horizontal line. Now put the value of t by 4. Here t by 4. Omega value is what? 2 pi by t. And t value, omega t, t value is t by 4. T, t cancel. You are getting t pi by 2. Pi by 2, sine pi by 2 is maximum. That means the voltage value is maximum here. This is the peak value of voltage. This is peak value of voltage. Okay. This is the peak value of voltage. And now what about the current? If you are putting t is equal to t by 4, you have got pi by 2. Pi by 2 minus pi by 2 is 0, sine 0. That means now the at t by 4 time the current is 0. So here this is 0. And the value of V is maximum at that time. Afterward at t by 2, if you are putting t by 2, so place it here t by 2, 2 and 2 cancel out, t and t cancel, pi, sine pi means sine 180, sine 180 means what? It is 0 again. So v value will come at 0, and afterward if you are putting here pi, pi minus pi by 2 is pi by 2, sine pi by 2 is what? 1. So you will get the maximum value. 1 means plus value here I. इसको थोड़ा सा छोटा बनाएंगे, ठीक है? तो यहाँ पर ये ऐसे वैल्यू आ रही हैं. दिस इज़ द वी ग्राफ, एंड वेयर इज द आई वैल्यू, वेयर द वोल्टेज इज एट पीक, आई इज एट मिनिमम. सो वोल्टेज इज मिनिमम, आई इज एट पीक, देन वोल्टेज पीक, आई मिनिमम, देन दिस वन. क्लियर? सो दिस इज आई वेव एंड दिस वन इज वी वेव. Clear? We have formed this wave by these two equations. Clear? And what is the conclusion here? When the voltage is zero, then the current is negative, having the negative direction. Okay? When the voltage is zero, the current is having negative direction. If the current should pass out here in this direction, here in the circuit, then it is not passing here in the circuit in this direction, it is flowing opposite. Clear? This is the physical meaning over the circuit. So means what? Ki current is lagging behind. When the voltage is zero, something value, suppose you are taking zero and you are taking minus two. So which one is greater, zero or minus two? Obviously zero. Minus 2 is a smaller value. So that means what? When the voltage is bigger, having the bigger value, having no direction, then the current is having opposite direction and having this smaller value. So current is lagging and voltage is leading. Voltage is having greater value and current is having a smaller value. And in different, in opposite direction. So that is why we can say that current lags behind the voltage. Lags means पीछे जाना. So this is the important conclusion. ये conclusion generally बहुत से form में पूछा जाता है, बहुत से combination question में आता है, that in the C circuit current leads over the voltage while in the L circuit current lags behind the voltage. So that is overall conclusion, and this is the wave formation, and this is the main conclusion of the circuit here, L circuit. So in L circuit voltage lead, इसी को आप कैसे लिख सकते थे, इसी को अगर आप दूसरे फॉर्म में लिखते हो तो ऐसे लिख सकते हो that voltage leads over the current. Both are same thing. Current lags behind the voltage or voltage leads over the current, both are same thing. So this is the main conclusion of L circuit, and which is opposite to the conclusion in C circuit. Now next is what? Phasor. And then we will find the average power. So if we want to draw the phasor for L circuit, then as I told earlier, there is no value over the y-axis, over the x-axis, because it indicates the rotation value of V and I. So that is why if we are taking the voltage here at omega t angle, initial V equation is what? It is V naught sine omega t. So initial angle for V vector, that is omega t. So I value is what? Omega t minus pi by 2. Pi by 2 means what? Perpendicular. 90 degree means perpendicular. So it should be, this I vector should be perpendicular to V vector first of all. And the angle between the two is what? It is pi by 2. That is 90 degree. Clear? So that is I lags behind the voltage because it is coming in the fourth quadrant, which is the negative direction. So that is why I lags behind the voltage. Kitne angle vary kar raha hai? Omega t se pi by 2. To yahan pe pi by 2 angle vary kar jayega. Then we will get the I value. So this is the I value here. Got it? So this one is the phasor for L circuit. Ye specific phasor hai. Sare circuit ke liye ek nahi hota. This is for L circuit. Okay? For C circuit you have got this Vs here in this direction. तो ये आपके दो टर्म्स निकल के आ गए. अब लास्ट टर्म बचता है. देखो मैंने आपको कौन कौन से टर्म्स बताए थे. फर्स्ट टर्म V, जो ऑलरेडी गिवेन होता है, V इज इक्वल टू V नॉट साइन ओमेगा टी. देन I, वी कैन गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ I बाय इक्वेटिंग द इक्वेशंस. ओके, देन एवरेज पावर, देन वेव फॉर्मेशन एंड देन फेजर. सो यहाँ पे वेव फॉर्मेशन एंड फेजर हो गया है, तो नेक्स्ट टर्म क्या बचता है? एवरेज पावर. सो वी विल कैलकुलेट व्हाट वाज द एवरेज पावर व्हेन आई सॉल्व द सी सर्किट. दैट वाज जीरो. एवरेज पावर कितनी आई थी? जीरो. आर सर्किट में कितनी आई थी? दैट हाफ ऑफ द पीक वैल्यू ऑफ पावर. क्लियर? सो दैट मीन्स वॉट? अभी मैं लास्ट में, जब ये सारे सर्किट कंप्लीट हो जाएंगे, लास्ट में मैं एक टेबुलर फॉर्म बनाऊंगी जिसमें मैं सारे सर्किट के आई, वी, वेव फॉर्मेशन, एवरेज पावर, फेजर, ये सारे बनाऊंगी. दैट कंपैरेटिव स्टडी, सो दैट यू मे गेट ऑल द सर्किट इन अ वन पेज, एंड दैट विल बी वेरी बेनिफिशियल टू यू. एंड आई एम श्योर दैट यू हैव नेवर गॉट दिस काइंड ऑफ दैट शॉर्ट नोट्स ओवर ऑल द सर्किट्स. क्लियर? So here, this is the phasor for L circuit, and now average power. So if you are going to solve average power, then average power is represented by this one. Again, the Fourier function, those who have attended the last classes, all four classes, four lectures here in this chapter, they know that how to solve the average power by Fourier function. So 0 to t and vi, power is what? Vi, and this is dt. 1 over t ki hai. So 1 over t and this is dt, integration for the full cycle. The formula should be this one. And we will put the value here, 1 over t integral 0 to t. V value is v naught sine omega t, as I have written earlier. And I value is mentioned here. It is I naught sine, this is omega t minus pi by 2 dt. So first of all, solve it. V naught, I naught you can take out, because it is the peak value, it is constant. And afterwards, 0 to t sine omega t sine, because sine is the odd function, तो आपने जो पहले इसके पहले step किए थे इस equation से पहले, you will just reverse the these steps and you will get the terms in cos form. So here, when you will take out this minus sine out of this sine term, so then you will get it sine pi by 2 minus omega t. So it will come as minus. First of all, take out the minus here outside. So sine pi by 2 minus omega t means sine 90 minus theta, which is equal to cos theta. So theta is what? This one is theta. So we will get it is omega t. That means we have just reversed the step what we did here to get the equation number 2. Are you getting my point what I am doing here? If you have any confusion, cast to me and I will surely give the response to you. Then average power here, you will get it as V naught, I naught, we can write it as P naught divided by T. V is the peak value of voltage, I naught is the peak value of current, and that is why V naught, I naught, VI is power, so P naught is the peak value of power. Clear? Now, if you will solve this term, then multiply it by 2 and divide it by 2. Then multiply it by 2, 2 sine theta cos theta is sine 2 theta. So, we will get it as sine 2 omega t, theta is omega t divided by 2, multiplied and divide kiya tha apne, divided by dt. So take out this 2 outside the integral value, so you will get it as 2t, and then you will solve this integration. So sine 2 omega t minus sine, where was the minus sign? Outside this, you have taken this minus sign, this is minus sign, this is minus sign, and now sine theta integration is what? Minus of cos theta. So you can take this minus sign out of the integration value. This minus become plus, and the integration of this value will be cos 2 omega t divided by 2 omega. Clear? And you will put the limits. Then here p naught by 4 omega t. That is the value here. And afterward put the value of t. So just consider this term, 2 omega, in place of a small t, capital T you are putting. So 2 into 2 pi by t into capital T, t and t cancelled out, it is 4 pi. What is the result of cos 4 pi? Cos 4 pi is equivalent to, see this system, is it 0, it is pi, it is 2 pi, it is 3 pi, this is 4 pi. So at 4 pi, the value will be same here as the 0. Cos 0 is 1. So here you will get the value as 1. So in the first one, you will get the value 1. And again, for the next limit, cos 0 is 1. So what is the result here? It is 0. Average power in case of L circuit is also 0, similar as the average power in C circuit. Theek hai? Clear hai? So average power in C circuit and average power in L circuit both should be equal to 0, while the average power in R circuit should be half. Means isko simplified form mein samajhne ki koshish karo, practical form mein if you want to understand it, that what is going on if there is only R circuit, no capacitor, no inductor, then the power is consumed in the circuit, which is equal to the half of the peak value of the power. But if you are using purely capacitive circuit or purely inductive circuit having no resistance, practically it is not possible. एनी डिवाइस एनी इलेक्ट्रिकल अप्लायंस मे नॉट हैव जीरो मे हैव जीरो रेजिस्टेंस इट इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल मीन्स एवरी डिवाइस मस्ट हैव द स्मॉल वैल्यू ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस इवन whether it is close to zero but it must be having some resistance value so this is not practically possible that average power is zero because it is a very beneficial condition for us that average power consumption is zero then that you will not get electric bill getting my point or not if any if it is purely inductive circuit having no resistance value that means average power is zero if you are not consuming power that means what should be your electricity bill it should be zero getting my point is it clear to you so it is not practically possible because every circuit is having some resistance keep it in your mind every circuit must have some resistance so that is why this is practically not possible but if it would be the ideal situation then we would not get any kind of electricity bill even using all the electrical appliances so that is not possible so that is overall L circuit I hope this L circuit is clear to you now come to the next circuit LR LR CR LCR LR CR LC not LCR LR and CR we will take these two terms LR circuit and CR circuit. Now we will do all the term in short. So let's start with LR circuit and CR circuit. This is LR circuit. Listen carefully. If you have not attended my previous lecture, you are not able to understand this lecture. Every topic is interrelated in AC chapter so that is why just go through the previous topic previous lecture all the four lecture which I have described earlier and then come to this lecture if you are viewing the video at very first time then here this is LR and this is CR circuit in the series combination of the two this is AC mains and this one is R resistance this is capacitance C then what we have to do first of all the basic equation V is equal to V naught sin omega t V is equal to V naught sin omega t afterward we are going to find out the terms related to LR circuit and we will not apply the basic method which we have applied in the previous circuit because now we know many things regarding the circuit like how can we get the phasor and what are the result of phasor in L circuit and C circuit and R circuit what are the value of average power in R circuit C circuit and L circuit so we will use that basic terms here directly and then we can conclude the result that whatever be the value of current in LR circuit what is the value of net voltage in LR circuit what is the value of average power in LR circuit and one more new term that is impedance so start with this we will start with phasor so if we want to draw the phasor so we must know the basic fact there should no values over the x axis and y axis first of all the L circuit voltage leads over the current and in R circuit voltage and current both are in same phase so if we are taking that voltage across the resistance here in x axis then it is VR and because the current moves in the same direction of the voltage so that is why this I current should be in the same direction now these are the direction means vector values of this I and VR now come to the L circuit the voltage across the L circuit is represented by VL and voltage leads over the current so lead means what we have to take the positive angular value and because the voltage leads over the current by pi by 2 value we have solved the L circuit कितने एंगल वैल्यू इंक्रीज कर रहा होता है, पाई बाई टू. सो वी विल अप्लाई द लीडिंग ऑफ द वी वोल्टेज अक्रॉस द इंडक्टर बाई पाई बाई टू लीडिंग ओवर द करेंट. ठीक है, सो वी एल इज अलॉन्ग विद द वाई एक्सेस एंड वी आर इज अलॉन्ग विद द एक्स एक्सेस. इफ़ यू आर टेकिंग दिस इन दिस मैनर, इस वे फेजर को हम ऐसे भी बना सकते थे, तो मैंने सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म बनाई है. इफ़ यू आर टेकिंग हेयर वी आर, देन आई आर शुड बी इन द सेम डायरेक्शन, आई शुड बी इन द सेम डायरेक्शन मेकिंग एन एंगल ओमेगा टी, देन वी एल शुड बी एट द 90 डिग्री फ्रॉम दिस वैक्टर वैल्यू, दिस इज वी एल. सो वी कैन ड्रॉ दिस फेजर इन दिस मैनर टू, दिस इज ऑल्सो फेजर, एंड देन वी कैन अप्लाई हेयर द रिजल्टेंट वैक्टर like this way v, and we can put the law of parallelogram here. Okay, to find out the resultant vector, what we have to put? The law of vector, a parallelogram. So that is one consideration. This figure must be some complicated to you, so that is why I have taken this simplest figure to you, so that you can solve easily the values. So we have to find out first of all what should be the resultant voltage value across this 2L and R, यानी इन दोनों का नेट कितना आ रहा होगा. इफ़ द नेट वोल्टेज अक्रॉस दीज टू वैल्यूज इज वी, देन व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ वी हियर. सो बाय द फेजर डायग्राम वी कैन टेक द रिजल्टेंट हियर एज इन दिस मैनर, ये रिजल्टेंट हो जाएगा वी, एंड वी कैन टेक द एंगल सम एंगल हियर एज फाइव, एंड वी कैन ड्रॉ द रेक्टेंगुलर फॉर्म, एंड वी कैन अप्लाई द लॉ ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू law of parallelogram theorem, this resultant vector v square should be equal to r square is equal to what, p square plus q square plus 2pq cos theta. So cos theta here is 90, so cos 90 is 0, so we will only put the vl square plus vr square. Any confusion? Yes or no? Then v is equal to under root of vl square plus vr square. So that is the result of the net voltage. That means net voltage should be the relation like this way, under root of VL square plus VR square. Similar as the Pythagoras theorem. So you have applied it and you have got the result. This is equation number 1. Now you are applying the equivalent, or we can say it as the resultant resistance. We are going to find the resultant resistance here. Resultant resistance in the series combination R is equal to R1 plus R2, but it is not R, it is reactance, inductive reactance, and this is normal reactance. So from the same relation we can find out the value of resultant reactance. So resultant reactance is termed as impedance and represented by Z. The unit is again the same, unit can never be changed for the resistance or resistance equivalent value. So unit must be ohm only, and this resultant resistance corresponding to LR circuit is called impedance. So you will not use that resultant resistance. Resistance is not the exact word for this LR circuit, it should be impedance. Okay, so from this time only you will not use the resistance word for this combination of LR circuit, you will use impedance. Clear? So here if you are taking V, so V you can write V should be equal to I into Z. V means what? Total voltage. Total voltage should be equal to, according to Ohm's law, I into R. R is here is, it is impedance, so I into Z, the combination of the two. So that is why I into Z, that is equal to under root of VL square. VL means what? I XL square. Clear? आपने क्या represent किया था? Resistance across the L, that is called reactance, inductive reactance. So it should be XL square plus I into R square. ये whole square है, remember this. Now I you can take out, square आएगा इन अंडर रूट के बाहर, I हो जाएगा, देन अंडर रूट ऑफ XL square प्लस R square, एंड दिस इज IZ. I क्यों नहीं चेंज हुआ? बिकॉज दिस इज अ सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन, एंड इन सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन करेंट मस्ट बी सेम फॉर ऑल द कॉम्पोनेंट. So that is why I should be same for VL and VR. Clear? So this I and I cancelled out and you have got the term Z as XL square plus R square. So this is the resultant impedance. Now many of the questions in board examination have been asked previous year, like in the numerical form, calculate the impedance and the value of frequency is given, value of inductance is given, resistance is given, values, other values are given and you have to find out the impedance. So you can only calculate the impedance if you know the formula. So impedance in LR circuit, Z is equal to XL square plus R square. So this is the impedance. So here Z is equal to under root of XL square plus R square. So we have got the Z term. Now what should be the current value? Then current I is equal to V over Z. Now V value is the total voltage and you have got the value of V over impedance. Impedance value is this one. So you can calculate I in LR circuit if it is asked in numerical. Clear? Afterward, average power. Now average power corresponding to LR circuit should be equal to average power corresponding to L circuit plus average power corresponding to R circuit. Now average power corresponding to L circuit is 0 as you have solved earlier, and average power corresponding to R circuit is P naught by 2. So in case of LR circuit, the average power must be P naught by 2, equivalent to the average power in R circuit only. So this is the formula for average power. So you have solved all the term by using phasor. So that is the importance of phasor, that you can solve every circuit, every combination circuit by phasor. Clear? Now come to the CR circuit. You can solve this term in the similar manner. And here if we are taking CR, so we will put here as first of all the phasor diagram in CR circuit. R, this is VR, so this is I, and because I leads and voltage lags by 90 degree, so this is VC. In the C circuit, voltage lags behind the current. You can see the direction here. Here it is lagging by pi by 2. So you will get the net voltage here V in this direction, and you can calculate the value by the same. That means you will get the net voltage as under root of VC square plus R square. That is the net voltage. Afterward, VR square. VC square plus VR square. Voltage ki comparability ho rahi hai. Afterward, what you have to do? You have to solve this impedance term. So you will put here only the IXE term. So you will get Z term as under root of XC square plus R square. What is XC? XC is equal to 1 over omega C. Remember this. Here XL is equal to omega L. So that is the difference between the two. Reactance, both are reactance. It is capacitive reactance. It is inductive reactance. And now this one is the value of impedance Z. Afterward, I, that should be equal to V by Z. And average power, again, it should be equal to P naught by 2, because average power in C circuit is 0 and average power is in R circuit is P naught by 2. So you will get it only P naught by 2. So that is a similarity in CR circuit and LR circuit. So I hope this point is clear to you. You can note it down or you can pause the video and see it. So that is all for today. So in my next lecture, if I will take LC circuit only, so that will be having only hardly 15 to 20 minutes, because LC oscillation is there. LC oscillation I will describe you. It is the most important topic, but yes, it is not very long topic like the LCR circuit. Okay, so what I can do, that I can solve some numericals along with that LC circuit, so that lecture may be complete. I may be satisfied with my lecture that I have completed the two topics at one day. Okay, so thank you for today, and next lecture will be LC with numericals.